Charlie as well off the other two. It kind of made it like you had no choice but to hit that one big tank.
It's the last person you want to be sinking all your damage into. But Legacy, they know that Luch is fabled for his Azir, so they take that one off the rift right away. Following the ban is Twitch. Once again, they don't want King getting his hands on that cheeky little rat.
Yeah, I got the Twitch off the board. The Azir ban as well from Legacy might be that they're putting all of their efforts towards the middle lane. Wouldn't be surprised to see a Ryze ban with it. And the question is, where do they go after that? If it is going to be that Ryze, because jungle still has a Nidalee present. Still a lot of strengths.
Victor, though, another champion that Luch has under his belt. So I think you might be right here, Rusty. There's no way they'll leave the Ryze up again unless, of course, they have to take it.
So yeah. Red side's got the mandatory Ryze ban. So as far as bans are concerned, this isn't a bad option by Legacy. It might actually force Abyss to ban out Luch. Maybe he defaults to his Orianna.
Yeah. Well, when everything is taken, looks
maybe
like they
have seen it. Tonight, yeah. Sin decided that it's good again.
Maybe Luch will follow suit here, but once again, Kuden unfortunately does miss out on his Soraka. So a lot of target bans this game, but it's expected in a best of three.
Yeah, absolutely. They've adapted ban number one. They recognized who the issue or the problem person might be. I like the response from Abyss by banning the Soraka opposed to anything like that Ryze. The standout kind of thing here. Trundle was the other one from Legacy last time around.
Ooh. There's going to be T-Gun's Karma that gets taken away from this one. So.
The mental battle continues, right? Yep.
They're basically just saying, you ban Raz. If you don't ban it, we're going to pick it. Let's see if Abyss Esports can deal with that.
And I still have to point out the fact that there is a Vladimir that no one's picking. There's also the Swain that was not attested towards in our first game of this series. Rek'Sai seems to be a high point of preference, as is the Lucian that's currently available.
First time Soraka, Nidalee's been available as well.
Yeah, so what do Legacy go for, knowing that Abyss are going to get two strong red side first rotation options? It's going to be very much a personal preference type of thing here. Is the Rek'Sai more valuable than the Nidalee? Nidalee probably more valuable, let's be honest. The Elise also, Carbon quite capable, but Seb did well on it. And you've got what does Choose have that perhaps is the only thing left for Luch. I'd say Gangplank. Maybe that's where they go.
Let's see what they end up picking away here. 20 seconds left on the clock. It is going to be the Nidalee in the hands of Carbon. So we're about to see why this champion has received 5 bans across the entire night.
Yeah, Nidalee pokes her head out. Still a very strong champion, not on the live patch that's had the jungling changed also. See how Carbon does go on this one. Still a very buff jungle choice. Seb probably just going to respond with something standard of his own. Yep. Man's got deep pockets when it comes to jungling. Kindred's also there. You would assume Seb will look towards that. And with anything else on top of that, perhaps it's the Trundle. You'll find that Abyss' first draft. We're pretty good.
So many great champions available. You'd think they want to pick them all here, but the safe one might be this Lucian on the in the hand of Raid. Trundle going across to Pac-Man. You mentioned in game number one just how good Pac-Man is when he gets that troll with the club, and we're going to be seeing that tonight.
It's one of the few times we've seen Pac-Man go huge and actually carry for his team whilst being able to be that tank. Mm-hmm. And so as far as drafting goes, they've now put themselves in a position where they can flex that Trundle if it were to come to it, dependent on what Minky Whale looks towards. And I guess the question needs to be brought up then of what does Minky Whale go towards? Does he commit to Italia, or does he play something a little bit more Minky?
The Swain and the Ezreal are going to be locked in here. And of course, when you can't have Lucian, you have Ezreal. And you've been talking all night about just how hyped this Swain is. We're going to see that in the hands of a Legacy member.
Yeah.
Think it'll be Minky, or do you think they'll send it to Minky?
Well, we don't know.
That's the thing,
right? Shoes will be quite good on the Swain, you would have to imagine. We also don't actually know if Minky Whale can play it. We just know nothing about him, let's be blunt.
Sure.
We know he plays Talia. That was our research. He has a pocket Hecarim if you want to go deep.
Let's see if Legacy are on that same train of thought here, but how will Abyss answer to this Swain pick? They've already got the Trundle and very unfavorable matchup, but Luch, he's very good on this Gangplank also.
We already mentioned that he can play the Gangplank, that they can also lock in the Kindred, which is the other top tier jungle choice. Yeah. As far as drafting goes, both teams are just going to have the most broken team compositions. They're going to run into each other with their brokenness until one's more broken.
Yep. Two broken glasses just shanking each other to death here. One will go down first, but
yep.
Legacy pick here.
Round that one out with a Maokai, not a Yi. Call it a day.
It is Minky where we are talking about
here.
Let's
go Aurelia.
Good point.
Do it. Minky, do it.
Rusty's calling you out, Minky. Go that Aurelia. You played some mean Aurelia last night yourself, Rusty.
Was it?
Yes.
Phantom Dancer is not the best side of build.
Looks like they will be going for that safe pick on the Maokai, so rounding it out. So Minky, well, I'm sure you can play a Maokai. Who can't in that top lane? Very simple champion in Kuden. When it knows Soraka. When in doubt, go the Braum. Big burly man with a door for a shield. What's not to love?
Yeah, and I guess not knowing where anyone is in the way of mid and top from the side of Abyss before they round out their support role. Better safe than sorry, and picking up the Braum themselves seems like they don't want to give that one over.
That's an intense solo shot.
Yeah.
Staring at my soul here, Tigon.
I was looking at the timer, really, at that point in time, and now you mention it.
Yeah.
He needs to
that solo shot, yeah.
Still, I think it might be the support being locked in here.
Sure.
You would have to imagine. Mm-hmm. Tigon can play that Trundle, though, so now that they know it's a Maokai, if they really wanted something like an Echo, they
now's
could
the
look
time
toward
to
that.
Yeah.
If they wanted something else in the middle lane, Pac-Man can play that GP also.
Definitely a lot of time being invested into this decision, as a one game here will put them up over Legacy. A wrong pick, man. Spiral them into the best of three. Looks like they want to go with the Morgana. Should be locked in here any second, and it is.
Oh, Morgana, very good into Braum. Will be quite nice into most of Legacy's team composition. And that's recognition of the lack of physical damage that they currently possess as a team.
That's a great point.
So magic resistance, definitely a stackable thing. Pac-Man, the sooner he gets a Spirit Visage, the harder he will be to kill. And by the end of this game, if it goes to like 40 minutes, there's probably going to be a scenario where Pac-Man can look at two people on the side of Legacy and shrug as he walks past them and takes their
not
base.
Not even acknowledge him, not even bat an eyelid, just walk through with the club, start destroying the towers. But we've got Luch on this gangplank, and what better champion to farm with, right?
Yeah, but he's going to be against the Swain.
That is true.
That doesn't make things easy. It looks like we're running the four teleports also between both of these teams. A lot of map movements capable. Legacy still showed they can early game lane swap with Minky in the roster because Carbon is that shot caller. You know, mm-hmm. It makes a lot of sense that he's going to be able to tell you where to go and when to be there. The question to me is still, they banned out Luch. They targeted his champion pool, but only in the way of control mages. We know he can still play Gangplank, and they've given him this opportunity. So probably a risk. He can still carry it.
Well, make sure to take to Twitter, guys, and tell us why you think Legacy or AE are going to win. Hashtag LGC win if you want Legacy to take it to game number three. Or if you're an Abyss Esports fan and you want them to close it out tonight, hashtag AE win.
I think it's safe to say before we get into this second game of the series, very few people expected to say that Abyss would be 1-0 up against Legacy, who were one of the grand finalists of our last split.
Look, we mentioned this is their time to do it, and they're showing up tonight. And Luch on this gangplank, I'm really excited to see what he can do here. Taking strength of the ages, though. Is that common?
On
gangplank.
Gangplank? No, it's not common. Grasp of the Undying is usually what he would be looking towards,
especially,
and I'm not
going to
be surprised if this graphic has made a mistake.
Sure.
I don't doubt our graphics guy. In fact, he's fabulous. But surely that's a Grasp of the Undying, or Luch has made a big mistake.
Yeah, that's going to be a little bit difficult for him to stack up those health bars, but...
And it is confirmed as well. It's the strength of the ages. Yeah.
It's going to be very difficult for him to get the most out of that. Would have much preferred a Grasp of the Undying, but of course it is confirmed that is strength of the ages. So Luch, he does like to push up the mid, go over and take the Raptors. Now he'll be getting a little bit more than gold to his name, but...
You wanted Grasp of the Undying.
Yeah, you want to, especially against Swain, who's just going to sustain the heck out of you. And Orange isn't enough here.
Of course, no Ignites to be seen as well across the board, except for T-Gun, which I will say, in comparison to our first series against the Swain, something that you might want to have. Less of a lane-conscious decision, much more of a get-to-the-mid-game and be relevant.
Does gangplank passives essentially a mini-Ignite? Does that have the healing reduction on it or no?
It's just true damage now, isn't it?
Sure. Wasn't 100% sure. It's been a while since I've played the plank. I always suck at using the barrel, so
Does still have the bandit part of his mastery secured, so 12 into the middle tree. At the
Carbon.
Very least.
It's getting bullied out here by T-Gun. Camp is going to reset.
Carbon, don't go back to it.
It's all about pride at this stage. Just Pac-Man, though, on the side of red, take a lot of damage.
It's kind of funny, because Minky's doing the same thing as he did in the first game, and it forces T-Gun to want to go back towards his lane and actually help out. But look at him.
He's still there. That still being a nuisance.
Morgana.
Oh, this is costing Carbon so much time. Doesn't
he
have the
no
smite, smite either. There it is, the Ignite. One more ornament attack should be the first blood. Goes to T-Gun out of nowhere. He's going to get the Krug as well.
Minky might get the Krug. Here no we way. Go. Oh, yeah, nailed it. T-Gun well and truly on the board for Team Abyss. The cheesiest move in history, but also predictably T-Gun.
Mm-hmm.
That Ignite, we just mentioned how important it'll be into the middle game. Turns out, early game. You still want that.
Yep. Ban away is karma. He's going to make you pay for it.
But that's inexcusably aggressive from Carbon to try and secure the Krugs.
Yeah, it's without
he
a
just
smite.
Didn't need to do that. Just go over to red buff, maybe even go over to the blue side of the map and take that. Play to where your strengths are on the map. He got way too greedy and aggressive for it.
Yeah, he's going to pay for that one with a very big loss of tempo, loss of jungle camps, loss of experience and gold as well.
One does not simply start the Krugs when T-Gun is invaded.
You're exactly right here, Rusty. And already about 10 CS advantage for Seb. Barrel's coming through. Here is Seb. Choose. He's going to have to flash. It might not be enough. If Seb chooses to go in for it, there is Wolf chomping down for a second kill of the game going across the Abyss.
I think it's safe to say 3 minutes into this game, Legacy are currently in red alert.
Tilt City.
Disaster zone. I'm not going to say Tilt City.
Sure. I'll say it then. Tilt City.
I mean, sure, that's your opinion of it. I think that they will establish themselves okay. They just need to try and damage control. This is not the way that you want to start this one off by any means.
Especially already down 1-0. Really need to find a way to stop the bleeding. Let Minky Whale get tanky. Let King find his groove, because right now Carbon and Choose have met unfortunate ends.
Yeah, and of course, Summoner's burnt in this middle lane. Gonna cause some issues if Seb reoccurs with his ganks.
Swain's auto attack is so bad as well.
He has the Q to put down anyway, usually helps with last hitting, but he didn't want to push, so he sacrifices a couple of last hits for the greater good.
Luch teleports his way back into that mid lane to ensure that he keeps his CS quite high. Doing what he can to get those Silver Serpents.
Yeah, this stage in the game as well, running that bandit. It's more efficient occasionally to last hit, or to Q choose rather, poke him out. You'll never out trade him. But every trade's a good trade. Now he has Sheen actually, I take that back.
Ooh, narrowly avoiding the barrel of the bird laser comes through. The orange.
Yeah, no, Luch is winning this lane till further notice simply because of the items that he has.
Never move, just gonna miss there, locking up the minions, but. Choose unfortunately going to have a bit of difficulty last hitting under this tower of raid. There's a big minion wave to play with.
And they're choosing to stay in this lane as well. That's the other thing, is they haven't swapped back. Mm-hmm. They're not continuing the standard lane swap. They match it. They want to fight them for it. And it makes a lot of sense.
Oh, Nidalee is there. T-Gun might be in a little bit of trouble. Carbon looking to get revenge on that one. King is over the wall. Does T-Gun have flash available? Doesn't matter as Carbon gets a little bit of revenge.
Yeah, T-Gun actually way too aggressive. Carbon absolutely does find that revenge. Seb is still ahead of him in terms of jungling, but that is a big step back in his direction. You'd be very pleased with that if you're a Legacy player. Exactly what they needed.
Just really making good use of that aggression. They know that T-Gun, he's never one to back down from a fight, but raid! Oh no.
No jungle camp goes uncontested from Abyss right now. They are making Carbon's life generally just miserable. Minky might be trying to respond in the same manner, however.
Oh, doesn't get that one away as Seb secures it, but
Choose
here
has got
comes
a good
Choose.
Play.
He's coming from the right side. Seb doesn't have flash available. Should be going down here. Should be no problem handing that one over to Choose. Gets himself a blue buff.
Yeah, and making sure the Choose gets it is quite important. So the Swain finds himself whilst behind in this lane, up with a kill now, turns to make things slightly better. Just wants that level 6 mark. Legacy, they damage control well.
Yeah, they really do. Very impressive stuff. Finding that kill into T-Gun, then Seb as well. So both the members are kind of evening things out here, right? It was Seb and Tegan that got Abyss ahead in the first place. It's the over-aggression that ends up costing them.
Yeah, it's the kind of lead that started off so well, and you would look at most games and say, well, this is actually just a disaster. The snowball's already about to happen. But over-aggression from Abyss, thinking they can take more than they can, and they pay for it.
Luch has hit that level 6. Got a cannon barrage available. Should any of his teammates need the cross-map assistance, but choose. He's never going to be low on health again.
Nope. The Swain is level 6. The bird absolutely is the word from this point onwards. Luch will just be farming, though. You see that? It's a level 7 power spike that the Gangplank has, level 13 being the other one, because the ultimate, it's always good. It's nice to have. But level 6 onwards, though, doesn't matter too much what level it is. Whereas you get that reduced keg timer.
It's very nice to have.
Which is what you get at 7 and 13, respectively. Find a lot more strength in the back pocket of Luch.
Ray just down here by himself. Tegan trying to make plays elsewhere on the map, along with Seb. So Ray, he's fine to farm it up. He's got himself the Cull. Only 75 stacks left on that one, so shouldn't be expecting anything much from him for a while. Whereas, of course, King stacking as well with the tier, so both these AD carries just in scaling mode.
Yeah, and both supports playing reasonably cautious as well. It felt like a 1v1, but this is still going to be a push back towards Abyss, and they've got essentially a freeze that has not been able to be broken.
Luch feeling the pain. That is the Swain in the top lane. Minky Whale, he's found Pac-Man. Pac-Man forced to use the ultimate quite early, but no tower to protect him. Minky Whale, he wants to go from this, but Pac-Man's getting bigger and bigger, but there are the minions there. The one Q back, which you're doing a nice flash from Pac-Man.
Yeah, very good flash from Pac-Man to get himself out. Had to use the ultimate respectively, so Minky's showing that he can still play that lane.
Ooh, another blue for Choose. It seemed like just seconds ago his was still on, so Luch is going to be feeling bad after that one, but Minkywell does have flash available. I don't think it's going to be enough. Oh no, the pillar blocked him off, but it should be fine if Seb can get in there, but no, here comes Carbon.
Oh, and even Chuchu's is suddenly above us. Hello.
Yep, Seb, he's in a world of hurt right now. A great teleport out of Choose. And respite being used, but the cancelled teleport from Luch means that Seb has no chance of surviving that one.
Yeah, and Minky flunks the flash, but it also just causes separation from the Trundle Pillar that Seb then flashes basically into. And Legacy turn back on that aggression. They get themselves an abundance of gold in that back pocket. Choose is big, the Swain is big. And when a Swain's big, usually you're winning on Summoner's Rift.
Tegan showing himself top means that poor Raid is all alone in this bot lane. Level 7 though, so does have the experience advantage having not to share that with a support laner, of course. But look at that Swain, already 2 kills to his name. Fully completed Rod of Ages, will be stacking along nicely. Luch being forced into that magic resistance build path.
Yeah, of course, costing 2,600 gold now, not 3k, means the Rod of Ages is a very good buy.
Oh no, Luch might be in trouble. There is Tegan teleport coming through for Minky Whale. Is it enough time? Has to flash and never move.
Luch baited by Tegan's presence there, remembering that Ignite was a possibility, but the immediate teleport out of Minky defuses that. Now they're stuck on defense duty. Not the best place to be.
Well, that bird is such great zoning potential from very relative safety.
Yeah, it is. And Swain's not going to slow down with his poke anytime soon. His harassment is just unbearable.
I see what you mean here. It's Luch. There's nothing you can do about it.
No, there's actually nothing you can do. And that's fine for Luch. He's very much a farmer. Mm-hmm. He wants to get as many minions as he can find, get some gold in that back pocket, and then look for a late game scaling fight. Hexdrinker into Trinity Force, maybe the next item he gets after that will be his big spike. But comparing to Swain, who hits level 6 and is suddenly the best character in League of Legends, that doesn't change when he hits level 7. It's just the best character in League of Legends.
Oh no, a lot of damage being dealt to Luch. Choose in full retreat. Carbon did cancel the recall just in time to back up his mid laner.
Just in time to watch Choose win anyway, that's the problem. Choose is never getting pushed out.
No.
It's going to take a lot of effort, and it means the T-Gun's probably going to have to be there out of necessity. I don't think there's enough all-in potential from a Gangplank by himself, let alone Gangplank and Trundle. I don't think there is either.
Puts a lot of pressure onto Ray to survive this lane and just look at Chu's completely relentless, taking tower shots because he knows one minion wave and he's back to full health, which is a few ticks of that ultimate.
Chu's still showing a lot of resilience. He does his fair share of damage, as you just mentioned. I mean, he's definitely mechanically still quite capable. Chu's just not using the ultimate though, holding onto that mana pool. Mm-hmm. The next wave that comes, you would imagine, he will start to gain that health back.
There we go.
Time to reset. Look at that. Oh,
Pinky Whale making his way down the teleport from Looch. Wants to keep this lane going for as long as he possibly can here.
And what makes this silly is that the changes to the catalyst aspect of a Rod of Ages gives you health back when you expend mana, and Swain gets mana back when he last hits minions. And so, like, it's a consistent cycle where if he's killing minions with his ult on, he's getting mana back, and that mana expansion is giving him health back. And he's a Swain whose ultimate heals him for flat values.
It's a dangerous cycle to behold, of course, as we see Legacy getting the first dragon of the game. He's getting the Infernal Drake. Good block from Kuden to ensure that Raid has nothing nice to say about him. Dodging out the spear here, so he is going to be answered with the Rift Herald being taken, of course. That will do nicely on the side of Pac-Man.
Yeah, Pac-Man still, we mentioned this during Champions, like one of the potentially large win conditions available to Abyss. They just want the Gangplank to hold on. You do still have to worry, however, for when the Swain wants to be in that side lane. But Pac-Man can stack Spirit Visage, and this was actually mentioned earlier during a Chiefs game where they played the Trundle.
Oh no, Looch is in trouble. He's going to get pounced on, taken down, tries to ultimate, but it's not going to matter as Chu gets himself another one.
Yeah, so they pick up a third kill for the mid laner of Legacy, and game number two is turned around, potentially into their favor. Still, Abyss are holding on. It's just that a lead is now starting to develop once more for our blue team.
Yeah, they're doing a great job despite small early game hiccups. But Legacy really showing that, really showing the strengths that we wanted to see in game number one. Like, look at the damage onto Pac-Man.
So I was going to say, surely they're not going to dive him, but they would. Whenever Swain has his ultimate available. A lot of poke.
The spear on the back of that one, the bird laser just slowing him down.
Yeah, but still waiting though. Pac-Man, we mentioned that he's going to have like a 5k item spike. Mm-hmm. Ravenous Hydra, Spirit Visage, means that even Choo-Choo's probably cannot deal with him in a side lane. And so Minky Whale has to step up and be able to compete or contest in the 1v1, at least clear those minion waves and thwart Pac-Man's advances.
Another blue buff going across the Choo's. He's feeling very, very confident in this laning phase, doing a great job of
he's
keeping
spoiled.
Up with each. Yeah. Had a lot of pressure, a lot of presence from Carbon early on, helping him get back into the laning phase after Seb visited early on. But looks like he's got a Ninja Tabby now, so even more difficult for Looch and Seb to make anything happen.
Three Ninja Tabbies actually completed Legacy. They understand that they don't want to take physical damage. And that's the funny thing to contrast, is we came in a champion set where, wow, Legacy, they have a lot of magic damage. Like, Trundle can just, you know, get himself a Spirit Visage, he's unkillable. Well, there's also a lot of physical damage on the side of Abyss. T-Gun's probably the primary source of magic. And so Maokai can just be like, oh, look, Sunfire Cape, Ninja Tabi into Randowins. Good luck.
He's going to be such an unstoppable tree once that Trinity of Items is completed here. Doing a good job of...
Frozen Heart, just get the good introduction.
Doing a good job of staying ahead in CS over Pac-Man. Also has a nice wave building. Still has his tower as well as... Choo-Choo's is just being obnoxiously unbearable. Might actually get taken down here. Luckily, he has the orange to cleanse out of a never move.
Yeah, Gangplank's very hard to actually take down. You only have one form of crowd control. He's been eating his oranges to stay healthy, however. It still does look like the tower's just going to go down.
Yeah, not a lot they can do. The barrel's still too weak to take out a whole wave of minions. So, Looch can be working on getting them a little bit more strong. Carbon in the top lane though. Pac-Man in a lot of trouble. Minky Whale's going in. It's all up to the spear. Can it hit Carbon? Applying the red buffs first. Very smart. A free spear. The takedown should be enough. Or do they give it across to Minky?
Yeah, they do. They make sure that Minky gets the kill. The flip side though, Abyss now looking towards this middle lane with a multiple amount of members. He chooses a... He's still a Swain.
Raid. He didn't get the memo that Chooz is an unkillable god right now. Ray's going to get stunned up, gets hit by the never move. One more tick should do it, but four members are there for Legacy, making their way down. A few more auto attacks onto him. There is Minky Whale coming through. The stun, one more auto attack should do it. He's not going to be able to get it in time. It's going to fall off. No, the Lamb's Respite does come out in time, but that's five members of Legacy grouping up to win the team fight.
And a whitewash right now for Abyss, 16 minutes into this game. And there is a 4K gold lead now for Legacy. They can't look at a Drake, but what they can start doing is getting down the turrets, getting down the structures, and growing that lead further, using that to try and snowball the rest of this game out and potentially bring it to a third. Abyss, if they're anything, they're defiant. See if they can actually hold against what is going to be an inevitable Legacy onslaught.
After that, we see Legacy in the lead. 9-2 already. 5,000 gold ahead of Abyss. This is going from bad to worse for this Abyss squad. They started out very strong, but recent events have kind of led them down this dark path where Swain is this unkillable bird monster, and there's no one but T-Gun with the means to stop him.
And the dark path was the patch notes that said Swain has been changed.
Yeah.
Never forgetty.
Thank you, Whale. Cute little dodge there to avoid the binding.
Swain. He's going to be, like, once he gets that zone, he's a good night to anybody on the side of Abyss. Mm-hmm. Still the same win conditions remain, however. They've got the farming gangplank. And he's working towards his next item, getting a bit of crit in his back pocket.
Carbon.
Legacy are probably just about to kill 7.
Carbon looking for something here. Minky Whale tanking up 3 members. Kuden also on the back of this one. The binding does land down onto Minky the Pillar. Should be enough to quell any further aggression.
And the same problem remains. They can put Chooz in the bottom lane with the teleport. Looch doesn't have one of his own. And the Swain into the Gangplank matchup feels a little bit familiar now, does it not?
Oh yeah, Swain is just rolling over him right now. There's not a lot that Looch can do.
300 damage kegs, huh?
It just gets healed in an instant.
You can be like an 800 damage keg. Still going to be cute.
Not a lot he can really do here.
Big gold deficit, however, between the AD carries.
Wow.
Abyss and Legacy.
I guess that's what happened when Raid is just stuck in a 2v1 lane, forced to give up.
Yeah. It's also the fact that there's two extra turrets there, that I believe King was recipient of some of the gold of that.
Second Infernal Drake in the pockets of Legacy with a mountain on the way.
No, this double Infernal Drake as well, like, all of them are doing damage. Minky Whale is a tank that's going to be killing people.
Looch has to flash out of that one. Gets caught by the never move, I do believe.
Pac-Man also cancelled teleport, and which means that Legacy can continue to push in this bottom lane if they'd like. I'm sure Chooz will try his 1v2 here. 1v3.
1v3 actually
here we
as
go.
Well with the gangplank support. They're trying their darndest to take him down. He's still alive. The minions actually aided him. Finally, they're going to get him as Raid takes down the Raid boss.
Yeah, they actually get the kill. It took an awful long time. I'm not sure the turret will fall just yet. They will get it. But meanwhile, what's happening in the bottom lane is the exact same thing. Abyss are not going to be foolish enough to try and contest it.
I mean, he falls, but he takes a good 10 seconds to do so.
And now has his Zonyas.
Oh, no.
So that thing, that whole 1v3 thing that we
that's
just
out the window.
Probably not happening.
T-Gun, they're trying to wait.
Got him.
The shield to proc, but it's not going to matter as Carbon, on point with his accuracy this game, takes him out.
Gets the bullseye. Of course, Abyss trying to stop recalls, given what they are doing in this top lane, rather. They should be able to actually get this one, you would think.
Yeah, doing a lot of damage here. No one going to be in position to stop them just yet. A few more auto attacks out of Seb should do it, and there it is. Two
not
towers.
Bad. So they trade. Actually work out getting potentially a tower in their favor. Doesn't mean that Legacy are going to stop chasing them right now.
This
is on the Baron side of the map.
The gold gap is being closed a little bit, but doesn't look like Legacy want to give up this one too much. Remember that King does indeed have the Iceborne Gauntlet as well as the Muramana. He's doing so much damage. One Arcane Shift should force the Lamb's Respite, and there it is. The ulti coming through. Seb narrowly avoids that one.
A lot of damage coming out of King. That was actually unreasonably large amounts of damage.
He's so strong.
The Ezreal is massive, to say the least. Raid going towards the standard crit build also wants to get an extra item before he's really doing a lot of work. Legacy, they commit to this. Abyss, no. And they do have members nearby, but not Seb, as he's in the base. It's going to be a difficult steal. T-Gun the
no
god.
Gangplank ulti either. Luch is going to have to do this one with barrels alone. Gets a lot of damage down onto King. Baron dropping down to about 1,000 health. It is going to get smited away, of course, by Carbon King, the recipient of the Nidalee heal. Now Pac-Man looking to try and get a five-man killer. Is it enough? Those Minky Whales turn around onto Luch.
I don't think the follow-up's going to be there.
You know, they're trying their darndest. Carbon keeping Minky Whale safe. Seb just gets smashed by the Kinkies.
And just the free Baron taken from Legacy. They've now got themselves the driver's seat. Potentially put themselves on this podium further. A lot of strength now. Abyss are going to get what they can from what was already a Baron taken. And that is a big take.
You would not think this is the same team as game number one right now. Legacy are showing up and showing us what they've got here. Seb might be in a little bit of trouble. No Braum ulti available just yet. Here comes King. The Braum ult is now up. Spear does connect. A Q connects. They're doing what they can. Seb, he's so low. One E should do it. No, it's going to get blocked by the Hex Drinker, but Tegan also falls on the back of that one.
Yeah, Carbon and King have got a lot of chase. Remember that Rylai's in Iceborne Gauntlet as King just ults Carbon for stealing it.
No, he's pushing the minion way.
Nah, Alt's Carbon for
Alt's
stealing
Carbon
it.
Alt's Carbon for stealing it.
Don't question me.
I didn't question you, Rusty.
I actually have no idea which one it was going for. I'm going to go with the former.
Anyways, looks like Raid just getting bothered here. As Kuden queuing that one to avoid the quick recall here. Choose just being such a presence this entire game long.
Yeah, this lead probably going to snowball somewhere outrageous if this continues. Luch is a good gangplank, but nothing compares to Swain.
Does get hit by that never move. Citrus is his way out. But already Minky Whale getting a nice push developing in that top lane. This tower should fall, and no one from Abyss can answer.
Yeah, now they need to hold the fort. Pac-Man is actually not that tanky unless he has his ultimate as well at this stage. This is a cool calm collected. Carbon!
Oh no, Carbon does get interrupted. He's got two of his teammates nearby. That is Braum and Ezreal, but he's a Nidalee, right?
Yeah.
A little bit.
Well, Minky teleported bottom lane also. Very aggressive.
Sure.
Because there was like 30 minions just chilling out. He doesn't want to overpush it, but he has no choice. He has a Sunfire Cape and an Iceborne Gauntlet. But really, Legacy just playing this as cool Karma collectors as they'd like.
Playing a very immaculate game right now, Swain. He's got his fully stacked Rod of Ages. Another Blasting Wand on top of that Hourglass, where of course on the side of Luch, finish that Trinity Force has the makings on Infinity Edge. Going to feel real good when he finishes that one off. Raid picked up that Phantom Dancer. You mentioned he does need that little bit of extra crit in order to be relevant, but comparing it to King right now, it's not a lot.
No, like comparing AD carries, it's not too great. Naturally, King's going to have more items. So we'll say the Executioner's Calling is going to be very handy.
Ah, there it is.
In reducing some of the damage that can be dealt by Choo-Choo's, which means item build as a choice. Very good style choice here from Raid.
It's good to see them acknowledging that.
Also, the Infinity Edge for Luch. They've got items, it's just not comparable. We'll see how they make it work.
1,000 damage barrels coming out. T-Gun having to book it out of that one. Luch instantly has to use the Citrus, but look at this overwhelming presence at Legacy. Are five members strong. They found T-Gun. It's Minky Whale in the fight. The Braum ulti being used. Seb on the back of that one. Choose. He's finally popped his ultimate. No one's going to die just in the first inhibitor falls, but members falling left, right, and center. That's a kill for Swain. That's a kill for King. And Legacy back off.
25 minutes into this game, and 14-3 is the scoreline. A commanding game two Legacy bite back hard, and they drain Abyss for everything that they are worth right now. This dragon will be a very easy pickup to follow. No steel threats, no team fight threats. Abyss just have no choice but to sit there and take the onslaught.
25 minutes in the game and already 7,000 gold in the lead. Our Legacy, three dragons, two infernals and a mountain. They're feeling really good about the pace of this game.
Yeah, pretty good dragon choices.
Ooh,
Mr.
Yeah.
RNG Jesus. RNGesus.
That's it, man.
That guy. That's pretty good. I'm going to take those objectives quicker. I've got a lot of scaling team fighting in the way of AD and EP. Legacy, honestly, nothing could slow them down from this point. They should just be able to pick a lane and win that lane.
Carbon's got himself a Rylai's now, so every spear that hits is going to be chase potential. Combine that with King, there is not a lot that Abyss can do to escape.
No, and there's also going to be very few opportunities for Pac-Man to be in a side lane by himself now.
Oh, the big flash from Minky while locking him down. The Q does connect. Where is the backup though? Kuden and King coming round to the right side. Looks like Carbon just going to let this trio of damage deal with it. The ulti goes down, not going to matter as he gets stunned up. One more attack from King should do it, and that's an unstoppable Ezreal.
Yeah, King does fantastic amounts of damage. Minky's got enough crowd control to keep him locked down, and Pac-Man just mentioned that he's going to have a hard time looking to split push.
Yep.
Well, that's all Abyss really have. And now that is completely out the window. Legacy picked top lane as their weapon of choice. See if they can make this one work.
Lightning lands onto Choose, but oh my lord, the heals on top of the Swain ult.
It's impressive.
Gangplank throwing down the Cannon Barrage. Doesn't really do much, they've got their sights set on this team. Give it to five members of Legacy all gathered round. Pac-Man still dead, but now Legacy can back away. Heads held high if they choose to.
They definitely should choose to. I know Abyss are going to try and chase him out. Pac-Man's got the flank.
He's in the flank. Where is the binding? It goes wide. Look at Juice in the middle of the fight. Doesn't care at all. Zonya's that one up. His health bar just ticking higher and higher. His team now there to back him up. He's got two members on the run. Takes out Luch. Takes out Seb. Reverse rather. Luch still running away. It's not going to matter. Here comes King.
Choose and King, the dynamic damage dealers.
Insanity.
Of Legacy should be enough, I think, at 27 minutes to finish this one off. Raid, the last.
Yep. Raid just going to get demolished here with a great spear. Pac-Man, the last hope that Abyss have, but it's not going to matter as they want to pad their stats here, taking him out. That is the ace. And three members of Legacy rocking a perfect score.
That's right. 28 minute win, 20-3 in kills, 3-0 in dragons.
Impressive.
Pretty much a well-covered victory from Legacy, and that's just a complete turnaround from that first game. There was no rise, there was no real way for Abyss to get back into it. But what Abyss did was actually start on the right foot, T-Gun getting a cheesy kill, Carbon getting over-aggressive, and then throw that all away back into the hands of Legacy.
Well, this ban phase is going to be so mid-focused. Every single mage is going to be banned away from the side of Legacy, and they have to get rid of this Swain now that they know what it can do.
Feels like the same thing as the first series, to be fair. Swain just should not be on the Rift.
Yep. All right, we're going to send it back to Spawn and the guys to break down that game for us.
Thanks so much, Rogi. And with that, Legacy will send us into game number 6 of the night because they hit back strong. But I kind of want to echo the sentiment of what the casters were just talking about. You start on a greedy side of the map, you get killed level 1. How does it feel as a jungler, Spooks, you know?
It's pretty rough, to be honest, and especially falling behind on Nidalee. I actually thought he was going to struggle for the rest of the game. He actually managed to turn it around really well. But I think that was a very greedy start by Carbon, knowing it was a lane swap. You'd pretty much, the majority of the time, you'd expect a jungler to start on the buff or Wraith, for example, because you have an easy out. But starting Krogs was pretty risky, in my opinion.
Yeah, it certainly was. So he dies. And I guess from there, we were like, I think it was 4 minutes into the game. It was 1,400 gold or something like that. Okay, cool. Yep.
Yep. Nope. Good handoff. No, so Carbon goes down and then Choo Choo's has some troubles in the mid lane. We're like, oh, crap. You know, this is going terribly wrong for Legacy. But then they get the replay and Swain gets ahead. Maokai gets ahead. And it's the solo laner. So that's really what helps Carbon catch back up is this idea that Maokai and Swain start just dominating their lanes.
All right, cool. So let's talk about the draft one more time because, you know, all the control mages go away. Luch goes back to an old faithful in the Gangplank, but they pick 480 into what is pretty much the unkillable team comp.
Yeah, so basically you have, obviously, as you said, the 480 and the options you have. First of all, you can't fall behind. If you fall behind, the game's pretty much over. Secondly, you want your Lucian to be a Black Cleaver, which is going to shred down the tanks. And you want Executioners against what is the Nidalee heal, the Maokai heal, and what heal am I missing? Swain heal.
Yep.
So, you know, obviously the win conditions are pretty rough, but it could have happened.
Could it have happened? All right, cool. So
could have happened.
We look at that because, like, a lot of those things were going in that direction. I mean, they did get the early lead. They were able to get a better swap because of how far behind Carbon was. But I think it was inexperienced players, or maybe greedy, because Seb continually invaded. I mean, you know, they just weren't able to get Luch the farm he needed. They weren't able to send enough people mid lane. So in the end, it did snowball. And it's what you were talking about one more time, Frost, like the idea of get an easy to execute team composition. Get a comp that just walks forward and be able to take over late game.
Yeah, we talked about, you know, I don't want to call it the wall comp a gimmick, but they pretty much just like threw that out, went back to basics, put Minky on a tank, an initiator tank. Minky's always been good in 5v5. Maokai's obviously incredibly powerful for that. And like literally that last team fight, Choo-Choo's did exactly what you said. He just walked into three people and there was nothing anyone could do.
Yeah, and in the end it was actually Legacy able to pick up the team fight with that walk. So they will send us to game number 6. Don't go anywhere, guys. In the end of 3.5 minutes, we will have the resolution of tonight as Abyss take on Legacy one more time.